Summer is around the corner and we are preparing for a lot of weekend getaways with the kids.
Yay!
And we have kind of come together and come up with a bunch of summer essentials for boys and girls.
Yes, and for every age, because
infants and toddlers.
Only 4 months old and Sebastian's a toddler, so hopefully this will come in handy for all age groups.
Yes. Okay, should we get started?
Yeah.
I'm really excited
about
this.
Let's show them everyone. So it wouldn't be summer without some
swimwear.
You guys, how cute is Aya's little swimsuit?
All right, you're hitting the pool. Cute. You need to have a cute little bikini to take a really cute little photo, because once you're done with your photo, you need to put a practical swimsuit on. So it's totally
my swimsuit.
Yeah, so it's totally Instagram versus reality.
Yeah.
So babies that are under 6 months old are not allowed to have SPF on them. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to expose your baby's skin to sun when they're so young.
It's so sensitive.
Like Aya goes out in the sun for literally like she'll be in her car seat and she gets red immediately. So always have a long sleeve swimsuit. Ani has a fun fact.
Sometimes they're called like rash guards or rash shirts. A lot of these are made with material that has SPF in it. I'm not sure what the SPF on this one is. Like Sebastian has a shirt version of it and this has SPF 50 in it, which is great because it prevents, even though he's old enough to have sunblock on, it prevents their skin from being exposed to the sun and getting a burn, which is really, really nice.
So I had gotten this, I think it was from Target for Aya, and it covers her body, but her legs are still exposed because she's gonna be in the pool. So it's still really cute. Not as cute as these, but it's still cute and practical, but it's also practical.
Yes. So these are Sebastian's little European swim trunks.
So
love
cute.
Them.
So cute.
So if it's like shade, it's totally fine. I'll literally just leave him in this and his little swimming diaper and I'll let him swim around. But once the sun is out during like the danger times, I either put this on him with a hoodie or with a hat to really make sure I keep him safe from the rays.
Don't forget the hat, you guys. Always have the hat.
And it's great when they have these little ties because Sebastian's always trying to take off his hat, so I'll like literally just tie it on him and then he'll...
So this last weekend, Ani and I had taken with our other girlfriend the kids to Palm Springs. So it was a big kid-friendly house and we had dressed all the kids up in their cute little swimwear. And we have a picture we'll show you guys right now. And they were just chilling like this.
These baby sunglasses are definitely not an essential, but they're cute for the Instagram photo.
Yes, you need that Insta photo. Aya took them very seriously. She was just wearing it and like a boss.
Yeah.
Like, no smiles or nothing. She was just
And this is Sebastian just like flirting nonstop.
Yeah, and
with this.
Sebastian in his photos was like, hey, Auntie Nora.
Speaking of swimming in the pool, you have to have some swimming diapers. I love the Huggies little swimmers. They're really easy to put on. You can either pull them up literally or it's literally just like regular diapers. And it does a great job of keeping all of the pee-pee and the poo-poo inside the diaper and not in the pool.
I was such an amateur this past weekend. I totally didn't take the swimmer diapers. And I got there, I'm like... my husband and I had a discussion in the room. We're like, what are we gonna put her in? What if she poops in the pool? Thankfully, our friend's twins are 7 months old, 8 months old, and she had a few to give me so I could use it for Aya.
Fun!
I didn't even know these existed.
Right?
So cool. So one thing that I feel like is an essential when you're at the pool, have a change of clothes for your baby, but make it like really practical and easy to get on. Mm-hmm. Because you don't want to take them inside with the wet clothes. They could get sick because, you know, Armo mom problems. I'm always concerned my girl is getting sick. So have like a little romper or bodysuit that you could put on them and like really quickly. Like this one has an elastic, so I just like literally just go over her head. This might fit you. And take her inside with normal clothes versus wet clothes.
I know Gap, like every summer or spring, has those terry cloth ones too, which are basically like little towels, so those are always great to get too.
Mm-hmm.
So of course, speaking of being in the sun and being in the pool, SPF, super, super important, you guys. Like Nora mentioned, you can't have SPF on your baby if they are under 6 months, but over 6 months, the one that I really love is the Baby Ganix one. I actually will fully like lather him up in the cream lotion version of the sunscreen, and then this is the spray. So I keep the spray in my bag, I keep it around at the pool, and I will periodically just spray him down to kind of like add extra layers of protection. Mm-hmm. What's great about this is I literally will just have it in my diaper bag or just like in my bag, just in general.
Sebastian's on the run, so it's like, get him, he's coming.
Right? Or like, you know, sometimes you're not necessarily expecting to be out in the sun. If he's in the stroller and he's wearing shorts and his legs are exposed, I'll just quickly spray him down. So it's always good to have sunscreen for the kids because mm-hmm. their skin is very sensitive.
Next up, water wipes. So water wipes are basically 99.9% water and just a little bit of fruit extract. I'm assuming that's the 0.1.
Yeah.
Always have this around when you're by the pool. It's always in my diaper bag. It's in my nursery. So I don't use wipes, like regular wipes, for her face because I don't know. I'm like weird about it. I use water wipes because I know at least that like it's just water. I'm cleaning up the milk from her face.
It's great for their face, for their hands. Yeah. Just, like, so small little cleanups.
If they're by the pool, they have to. Have a spit up. If they're by the pool, their hands are dirty, toes are dirty. If you're at the beach and there's sand, you could clean it off with a water wipe, so always have it handy.
Yes. So speaking of being at the beach and getting sandy, one thing that's really great about having baby powder, and of course we love the talc-free one, the Burt's Bees makes a really good one, is that, fun fact, you can actually use baby powder to remove sand from baby's feet and hands without like kind of like giving them a little rash.
Yeah.
So always a good idea to have one of these with you when you go to the beach.
Interesting. Fun fact.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I was going to mention his little summer shoes because they are beach shoes too. In the summertime, like, he doesn't really like to wear sandals, and I don't like to put like socks and like Nikes on him, his usual like playtime gear. So I recently invested in a pair of these Native shoes, and when I say invested, they were like $30. I like them because they have little holes in them. His feet are breathable. It's rubber. He can get it wet and it dries quickly. So I feel like these are really great to have for
super
toddler
cute.
Kids.
Yeah. I like to have a little toy with me when I'm by the pool or if I'm going to be at the beach or if we're out and about. Aya's going through her teething phase. So this baby banana actually Ani had gotten for Aya, and it's cool because it has like these little bristles. And she literally puts it in her mouth and she's like, "Oh!" It's like, it just feels so good. That moment, it's the funniest thing. I like put it in her hand and she immediately is like,
and fun fact, what's great about this teething toy compared to some of the other ones is that this actually helps promote teeth brushing. Oh. So I used to give Sebastian this all the time when he was a kid, and now when he was like an infant, and now as a toddler, I'll give him a toothbrush and he'll actually brush his teeth. So it helps him like prepare for that.
Does he brush like this?
He mostly will like start to brush and then just chew on it a little bit. But whatever.
No, this was, something tells me I was gonna brush your teeth like
aggressively. Sebastian is officially off of regular bottles and he's on sippy cups. So one thing I love to have with me is an insulated cup for water or for milk. And I really love the Fogo one. It comes in two versions. This one's just like a regular top, and they also have like a flip top that has a straw in it. And this is the Thermos brand. It's great because it really does keep his water like really cold and his milk really cold, especially in the summertime. Like, you don't want to drink like hot water.
Mm-hmm.
So love having this around.
It's the Thermos brand?
Mm-hmm. Cool. Cool, right? Don't worry, I'll get Aya one.
Okay, cool.
A wet bag. I feel like it's really important to have one of these wet bags around because if you are coming
changing
back from the beach, you're coming back.
Your baby.
Baby, you could put all of the wet gear in here. And this one is by the Skip Hop brand. You guys know how much we love Skip Hop. And it's nice because this folds up super, super tiny. It does not take up a lot of space. And then you can put all your wet stuff in here and it stays, keeps everything else really dry.
Speaking of Skip Hop, you have to have a little backpack for your baby so you can put all this stuff in there,
so
right?
Cute.
So I love Skip Hop's backpacks. I think they're so super, super adorable.
This is their zoo collection.
Yeah, and this is my little unicorn. And I like to put all of Aya's things in here before we head out. So she's like, you know, her own person.
Right?
And she's independent and she has her own bag. It doesn't need to be in mommy's bag.
And I love that it has like a little place for a bottle on the side and it has like a front zipper. The front zipper actually holds a lot of stuff in there, which is really, really great.
Mm-hmm. I still have my
You can put some wipes in here. You can put all the essentials in there.
Yeah.
So it's easy to
grab. And you guys, we're going to have a giveaway with them soon. So on our Instagram. So if you don't follow our Instagram, please, please follow us.
We do awesome giveaways.
ModaMob Official. We do awesome mommy baby giveaways.
Yes.
We do awesome makeup giveaways. Just saying.
What's left? Okay, the last thing I would say is kind of like a little bonus thing. I love to always keep one of these picnic blankets in my car. I think it's great as like an impromptu time. Like I take him to the park all the time, and sometimes it's nice to just throw this out and have like give him his little snacks if it's his feeding time, or we can just sit and hang out. And I got this literally for like $10, and it takes up barely any space in my trunk, and I just leave it in there.
So it's actually cool.
We were to have for the park or for the beach.
Yeah, we had taken the kids to the observatory, and we whipped that out and sat on there, and Sebastian was having his snacks.
Yeah, and he was trying to feed Aya.
He was. It was really cute.
Hopefully you guys found our infant, baby, toddler essentials super helpful for the summertime.
If you guys have any suggestions that we're missing here, leave it in the comments, because you know we're a big, happy family here. We want to learn some things from you guys too, obviously. And remember, you guys follow us on Instagram, ModaMob Official. We're going to be announcing some awesome giveaways very soon. And Skip Hop happens to be one of them.
We'll see you guys next time.
Bye.